workforce, men and women are subjected to these gendered institutions, where gender norms are enforced throughout the workday. From schedule changes to ideas of strength or intelligence, the work environment subtly impacts us on a day-to-day basis. Although not as obvious as it once was in the past, employers have found less evasive ways to show their disinterest in a certain person. For this, I will demonstrate how I myself noticed these while working as a parent educator at XYZ Middle School. Despite the monotonous nature of working at a job, this lack of observation prevents us from seeing the separation of women and men in the working environment. Being a parent educator at XYZ Middle School and one of the youngest staff employees, it's come to my attention that groups of men and women like to migrate together. Very seldom will they integrate with one another, however. We all know each other's schedules, as we tend to the same work, so there are opportunities to talk about what is on our minds at present. However, even this is one gendered most of the time. The only time I've seen co-workers, including myself at times, integrate and converse with other genders is when the supervisor is present, but not in our field of vision. Conversation seems to flow more smoothly unless forced or cut short. One's gender is a factor in the workplace even with just having a conversation, it seems, or has this been embedded into us by the institution itself, that we have to follow an invisible guideline that we have become so accustomed to we don't even know is happening. Sometimes structure can be masked as a control mechanism, which I'm beginning to see more and more. The female parent educators generally do all of the quote women's work, whereas the men do the heavy lifting. And since in this occupation there aren't a plethora of men, we are in high demand for our natural strength and steadfast nature. Sitting back and looking at our surroundings, we see this happening daily, though when we are in the grind of our labor, we have the blinders on and don't see a thing. This assumption of men being stronger and women being weaker is not something new. This is implicitly taught to a level that raises very little suspicion, despite several laws that try to stop this practice from happening. When the children at XYZ Middle School are about to leave for lunch, bear in mind I work in an adaptive sports center, so this may be different across the board, the women attend to meal preparation, where the men bring the lunches to the students. Again, at first glance, this appears to be a normal practice of a daily routine, though this is explicitly enforcing the hunter-gatherer or the breadwinner and homemaker ideologies of the 1950s. And as the above example shows, still continues today, because it's been ingrained into our culture. The workplace continues to demonstrate its role as an institution of gender. My own personal observations of it occurring at my place of work have made me become more aware of this practice, although even to me, this process continues to work like a well-oiled machine. From separating women and men into their, quote, groups and continuing the age-old tradition of gender roles, while adding the difference in dialogue between male and female interactions when the supervisor is not presently seen. Thus, the problem with the workplace is although it's become more open to all, it will take years, maybe even decades, for people to realize that when they go to their 9-to-5 job, their schedule and interactions with others is actually part of the cycle of the gendered institution known as the workforce. Again, all of my citations that I've used throughout this discussion will be in the description box below if you would wish to look more into this yourself. Again, I thoroughly implore you to do your own research. Do not take my words as fruit of the tree. Do your own analysis of this, and you can come up with your own conclusion. And if it's parallel to mine, great. And if not, you know, that's fine too. We're all human. We all have our own ideas, our own aspirations, our own dreams, and our own ideologies. Thank you very much for watching, and have a pleasant day.